Hi friends, tonight I will be reviewing Movie Edition Starscream. So here's Starscream in his jet mode. As you can see, he's a close facsimile of an F-22 Raptor. The colours are mostly a sort of greyish beige, and it's got some dark grey scorch marks that have been airbrushed along the wings, as well as some silver accents along the front of the wings, as well as the wing flaps, and also for the Decepticon insignia and various other places on the toy. Again, you can see there are also some more airbrushing along here. The cockpit has a silver lining and has a transparent amber coloured window. Okay. The undercarriage has some more darker black accents. Attempt to make Starscream look like a convincing F-22 Raptor, I think that Takara have done a reasonably admirable job considering what they were trying to accomplish. You have to remember that they're trying to marry an accurate F-22 Raptor jet mode with what is a very bulky robot mode. Alright, the movie Decepticons have these sort of bestial appearances in their robot modes, and Starscream's robot mode is very large. It's meant to be very physically imposing and intimidating, and it's difficult to extract such a bulky robot mode from what is a very thin sort of vehicle. So taking that into account, I would say that Takara have done a reasonably good job in trying to compact all that massive robot mass into a fighter jet mode. Okay, but as a result, you can clearly see there is a significant amount of robot parts in the undercarriage. Right, they've tried to minimize it as much as they can, but it's not possible to completely conceal it. Not even Masterpiece Starscream is able to conceal all of his robot. Alright, putting that aside, there's various play gimmicks to this jet mode. First of all, you can see there are two massive cannons underneath the wings. They're activated by these wheels underneath each cannon, very similar to the gimmick on Beast Wars Rampage, where as we roll the toy along, it fires the missiles in succession. Okay, which works something like alright. So you can see there, you know, it's a gasoline cannon sort of effect, firing the missiles off. It's a lot of fun. I have a lot of fun with it. And easy. Let's have a look at this thing in robot mode. Alright. First thing we'll do is to detach these cannons here. We'll just pull them out to the side. Okay. And then we take these two tail fins and we'll lower them down to here. Alright, then we'll open up this compartment here. Like so. Open up this hatch here. Pull this leg out and we swing it over. Close that hatch, and of course we repeat on the other side. Close. To either side, adjust the legs. Okay, the interesting thing about this design is that the nose cone drops, but the window section actually stays there. And actually see the details of the interior of the cockpit, including the pilot's seat and the various other controls, which is fairly neat. We lower this section here, which reveals the robot head. We lift up this part here. We then take these two fins here and then we rotate them to the front like so. Okay. Then we take these two wings and we separate them from the main body. It'll clip out like this, and you lift them up to here. And as you can see, this is the main automorphing gimmick. As I lift the wing up, the rest of the torso then forms into place. Okay. You then continue to swing these two tail fins down here. This part here from the cockpit will go up to here to finish forming the chest. Okay, let's lower the arm, shoulders get them out of the way. We then take these wings. Alright, we fold, so you can see it. We fold this section in like so. Do the same on the other side, folding that in. Okay. And then we fold both of these wing sections down. Once that's out of the way, these two tail fins then fold down to here to form the shoulders. Like that. Alright. Then we connect this nose cone section here. We'll go up and we put this peg into this slot in the back. Alright, then we basically bring the shoulders up, put them into position, place your arms into position, fold out the feet. Now if you want to make this toy more accurate to the movie model, you can also push these knees back to give them that sort of reversed hind leg look, okay, which is how you're supposed to transform it. But alternatively, if you don't like that looking, you want to make them look more anthropomorphic, you can straighten the legs. Another interesting feature is that from the Gatling cannons are fingers, which can pull out, which makes the cannons look more like hands instead of just having pure guns for hands, which is a nice touch. Okay, I must admit I wasn't really expecting that, and I'm quite pleasantly surprised we can do that. This cockpit section then can fold down, and this part can separate here to, you know, help finish the look of the chest. Okay. Now, with that's basically your robot mode there. The missiles can be placed either back inside these Gatling cannons, as you saw in the vehicle mode. Okay. And that's officially how you're supposed to put it. But another alternative way of storing the missiles, and particularly if you want to make the Starscream look more G1, are these two clips on either arm. There's one clip on either arm. You fold them out like so. Now they don't fire, but they can store the missile. Okay, you can see here I've now added the missiles onto these two storage clips, which to me gives this toy more of a traditional G1 Starscream look, because as I'm sure most of you know, the original Starscream had his missile launchers mounted onto his arms rather than firing out of his hands. They don't fire, but by virtue of simply holding them there, you know, kind of gives it that sort of G1 look. That is my review of movie Starscream. I think this is a really neat figure. It's well articulated, it's pretty solid, and considering what the designers were attempting to do, it's a fairly well executed form. Okay, I would definitely recommend this figure.